Yes.
That's enough for now.
Another time, then.
Yes? Did you leave anyone behind in Kirkwall?
No. I fear I made few friends there, and my family's in Ferelden.
No one special caught your interest?
I can't say I was looking. Honestly, I was not good company back then.
I might enjoy your company.
I would value your friendship. I'm afraid I cannot offer more. I trust you'll understand.
Did you need something?
Is there anything I should know?
The Lord Seeker's actions are a mystery, but the Templars will aid us. They cannot sit idle while the breach remains.
Why would Templars break away from the Chantry?
The Order believes the Chantry no longer supports their efforts, not to the extent they should.
But the Templars have served the Chantry for ages.
And in that time, they have come to take the Order's services for granted. Templars risk their lives against blood magic, demons, abominations, to feel as if those efforts are dismissed. I may disagree with the Order's actions, but I'm here as proof of that. But I sympathize with their frustrations.
What do you think of the people you work with?
Who do you mean?
What do you think of our ambassador?
We have little in common. How she delights in meeting with nobles all day is beyond me. But I enjoy working with her.
How do you like working with Leliana?
The Inquisition would not exist without her. I may not always agree with her methods, but she's more passionate about our cause than anyone. Cassandra may have declared the Inquisition publicly, and Leliana is just as responsible for its formation.
Are you satisfied with the Inquisition's forces?
Our numbers are small, but they suit our needs for the time being. Some Templars have joined us instead of following the Order. They've proven invaluable in training new recruits.
I should let you get back to work.
See reason. We cannot stay here.
Why not?
Because we're Templars.
What? I've heard about Val Royeaux. This is not right. I will not be joining them. At least the Inquisition does not stand directly opposed to the Chantry.
How did you come to be a Templar?
It seemed the right thing to do. My family are tradesfolk in Denarim. I could have become a cobbler like my father, but this seemed better. It's a chance to uphold the Chantry's laws and help the mages through a troubled time.
I'm surprised to hear that.
Not all Templars want to make mages into prisoners or villains. Some of us just want to keep a balance and let you practice your craft in safety. One person trying to do something can make a difference. You should keep that in mind, Harold.
Do you have any idea what caused the explosion?
No, I'm just a recruit. Belief and faith doesn't get you closer to the important meetings. Though that distance did save my life.
I'd like your take on the Templar Order.
It's a shadow of what it was. Where once we both protected all people from the dangers of magic, we now posture and grab at power. One day, I hope the circles are again sanctuaries where mages can practice their craft.
You're not going to rejoin the Order?
When the temple went up, your forces rescued those few of us still alive. My life is a debt I intend to repay, however I can.
I will talk to you later.
Walk in the Maker's grace.
Master Lavellan, on behalf of the Inquisition.
A pleasure, sir. We so rarely have a chance to meet anyone new. It is always the same crowd at these parties. So you must be a guest of Madame de Fer. Or are you here for Duke Bastien?
Are you here on business? I have heard the most curious tales of you. I cannot imagine half of them are true.
What have you heard about me?
Some say that when the veil opened, Andraste herself delivered you from the Fade.
I'm not familiar with that name. I was invited here by First Enchanter Vivienne.
Madame de Fer is a fond nickname the court has given Lady Vivienne.
I've heard she finds it amusing.
I've heard very little about Duke Bastien.
He hasn't been seen much at court lately.
His business with the Council of Heralds often takes him from home for long periods. It can't be good for a man of his years.
And of course, there's the civil war. Bastien probably wishes to distance himself from the actions of his one-time son-in-law.
Tearing up the Dales in a foolish bid for power? It will end in disgrace for Gaspard. Everyone knows it.
Everything you've heard? Completely true.
Better and better. The Inquisition should attend more of these parties.
The Inquisition. What a lot of pig shit. Washed-up sisters and crazed seekers. No one can take them seriously. Everyone knows it's just an excuse for a bunch of political outcasts to grab power.
I've never made any claims to holiness. What's your point?
In front of all these people, you admit to being a pretentious usurper. We know what your Inquisition truly is. If you were a man of honor, you'd step outside and answer the charges.
My dear Marquis, how unkind of you to use such language in my house to my guests. You know such rudeness is intolerable.
Madame Vivienne, I humbly beg your pardon.
You should. Whatever am I going to do with you, my dear? My lord, you're the wounded party in this unfortunate affair. What would you have me do with this foolish, foolish man?
I think the Marquis has seen the error of his ways.
By the grace of Andraste, you have your life, my dear. Do be more careful with it. I'm delighted you could attend this little gathering. I've so wanted to meet you. Allow me to introduce myself. I am Vivienne, First Enchanter of Montsimard, and Enchantress to the Imperial Court.
Is that Marquis going to pose a problem?
His aunt is the Vicomtesse of Mont de Glace. Not a powerful family, but well-respected. And very devout. Alphonse will be disowned for this. It's not the first time he's brought his aunt disgrace, but I'm sure it'll be the last. And after such a public humiliation, I expect he'll run off to the Dales to join the Empress's war effort. Either to make a good end, or to win back a modicum of self-respect.
Your salon has certainly exceeded my expectations so far.
I'm glad to keep you entertained, my dear. I wanted to meet face to face. It is important to consider one's connections carefully. With Divine Justinia dead, the Chantry's in shambles. Only the Inquisition might restore sanity and order to our frightened people. As the leader of the last loyal mages of Thedas, I feel it only right that I lend my assistance to your cause.
Is your interest in the Inquisition Madame de Fer, or is it more personal?
Aren't you charming? It's professional, of course.
You say you led the last of the loyal mages. Loyal to whom?
To the people of Thedas, of course. We have not forgotten the commandment, as some have, that magic exists to serve man. I support any effort to restore such order.
The Inquisition will be happy to have you, Lady Vivian.
Great things are beginning, my dear. I can promise you that.